They said to him, "We have here only 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Ordering the people to sit down on the grass, he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fish. And looking up toward heaven, he blessed the food, and breaking the loaves, he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And they all ate and were satisfied. I was just astounded at the compassion that Christ had, because he had just lost his beloved cousin John, who was beheaded. And when the disciples came to talk to him, it would have been easy for him just to have said, "Yeah, let's just send them away." But because of his compassion and his love, that was another thing that was striking to me, and how God always provides. From the time the Israelites were in the desert with manna, he gave them exactly what they needed. Now Jesus was giving the 5,000 plus all the women and children the same kind of thing. So it was a continuation of that.
'Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good.
So I actually did start this project some years ago and had all these color studies. I loved working on it. I've always loved looking at this beautiful plant. But I couldn't figure out exactly how to put it all together in one painting, which I wanted to do. So I just put everything aside. And then when this opportunity came up at the church to do something for Lent, and when I read that scripture, it just so beautifully tied in with the abundance of this bloom, the protection that God gives, the importance of light and dark in our lives. We need to, are just so many parts just connected to me. So I got it all out, and that's where I am. There are probably 30 to 40 layers of color before a painting is finally finished. And there are tiny little details that you use with a very tiny little brush to show all the things that that make it look more alive. This is kind of half dead. It just doesn't have a lot of oomph right now. So hopefully it will by the time it's all finished. And that's like life. It's a journey that never is ending. You can always improve. You can always learn. And you can always help others. So to begin the actual painting, I use a very thin wash of transparent yellow. And do that for each part, and then move on to the next. So in the photos, you'll see that progression of a very faint wash until I start to build up the color. And actually, all of the creative process that goes into botanical art is my personal spiritual journey. It is just such a blessing to wake up in the morning, look at God's creation, and see how it touches me.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
And you can look at life from all angles, from that perspective. And I thought of the generations of people that were there and how they shared. And you'll find out from these berries that are the final part. So this is like the beginning of the bloom, the full bloom, and then the berries. And inside of them, they contain these beautiful little pearlescent seeds that I was going to include, but it got just too much. But they're like little pearls. And I thought of the elderly people now that I'm part of this group, and just sharing pearls of wisdom to the younger group. It was just kind of a beautiful thing. Definitely there is an abundance of the bloom, and I think there is an abundance in our own personal lives with our faith and the way we share it. And the more that we share it, the more abundant our lives are. And I think it all relates to our attitude. We have to have the right attitude to be accepting of the gift that God gives us, that gift of grace. and to be able to look at other people more clearly, not through our eyes, but through God's eyes, in the way that they would look, and maybe appreciate the struggles that they're going through. So again, it's God's abundance of provision, abundance of life. And when I look at a plant growing, how it, if it's nurtured properly, it really thrives and grows well. If it's not in the right environment, it struggles. It's just amazing to me, just watching this whole plant and just seeing how God has created these amazing, beautiful plants in our lives. If He cares that much about this plant, how much more He cares about us?